The colourful trader's wagon coming towards you is unmistakable. You greet the driver once he is within earshot.
Good day, Mort. So, we meet again.
Ha! Indeed! What a pleasure to see you again, Tungdil. What can I do for you today?
Farewell, Mort.
Rakesh be with you.
Mort spurs his horses on, and you continue on your way. You arrive at a small, bustling village. One thing is clearly missing from the lively scene: the sound of metal on metal from the village smithy that would normally be heard above everything else at this time of day. A dour, grim-looking man is sitting in front of the forge with his right arm in a sling. His expression brightens as he sees you, and he jumps to his feet.
Dear dwarves, could I interest you in helping me in my workshop for a day?
The man's expression is somewhere between desperation and hope. As you don't answer immediately, he continues.
You will, of course, be royally rewarded for your work. I can offer you 100 gold pieces.
I could help you, but compared to human standards...
The smith gulps.
Give me 150 gold pieces. Then we have a deal.
That is a lot. But all right. I only hope that your skills are as good as you promise, Mr. Dwarf.
The smith is clearly unhappy that he has to pay you more. But in the end, the most important thing for him seems to be getting the work done. A little later, you are standing in the workshop, examining the smith's inferior tools, while he fires up the forge and prepares everything for the job, as well as he can, with just one good arm. You weren't able to persuade the twins to help you. As warriors, they'd rather go hunting, Boindil declared. But you think it's more probable that you'll find them drinking beer. But you don't care. You're excited about being able to smith again, after such a long time. Hours later, you have forgotten everything around you. The heat of the forge, the sweat on your warm skin, the play of the flames. You're in your element, and work as if in a trance. The smith left the workshop ages ago, with a satisfied grin on his face.
Oi, I'm talking to you.
You look up in surprise. Everything but the beating of the hammer had ceased to exist, and you didn't notice that someone has come in.
Can you do it?
You immediately dislike the middle-aged man. He sounds you out so doggedly with his light grey eyes that it feels as though he wants to look right through you and into your deepest thoughts. The man points to two horses.
Those two, in 1 hour.
With the forge hammer in your hand, you play dumb. You blink and look back and forth between the horses and the man.
What's the deal with the horses?
You expect the man to fly off the handle, but you feel even more uneasy when he asks you quietly and very slowly to please reshoe the two horses.
These two need shoeing? No problem.
The man doesn't look convinced, but you get to work with confidence. Two more armed men are standing next to the horses, sizing you up. You concentrate on the work. The only sound you hear is the melodic beat of the hammer against the anvil. You keep track of the armed men out of the corner of your eyes. You suspect they are mercenaries. While you're fitting the third horseshoe, another armed man enters the forge and speaks in hushed tones with the leader of the group.
He's the only one here.
The man nods in your direction, and you quickly shift your attention back to the work. You play it cool and complete the work. As the leader of the mercenaries pays you, you have the feeling that he is trying to transfix you with his eyes. The men leave the workshop without a word.
So, you're mercenaries, I take it?
You're only trying to engage in conversation, but the man looks at you incredulously, as if he didn't expect dwarves to be able to talk.
Something like that.
Got lots of work? Oh, do you know anything about the armies of orcs from the south?
We can't complain.
The man's tone makes it clear that the conversation has ended here. You carry out the work in silence. As the leader of the mercenaries pays you, you have the feeling that he is trying to transfix you with his eyes. The men leave the workshop without a word. The men join a larger group of horsemen, more than a dozen, outside the village. You stay hidden and listen.
Not here in the village. Go, search the road between here and Clintyre again.
The other mercenaries nod and the group rides off. You can't make head nor tail of what's going on here, but you don't like it. You tell the twins about your encounter, and they decide to be especially vigilant over the next days. You spend the night in the smith's house and move on the next morning. The color.
Farewell.
You are a do the man.
What happened to you?
A shoot low.
I'll help you. I worked in a forge for a while.
You modestly conceal that in this case, a while means almost a whole human lifetime. A little later, you are standing in the workshop, examining the smith's inferior tools, while he fires up the forge and prepares everything for the job, as well as he can, with just one good arm. You weren't able to persuade the twins to help you. As warriors, hours later, you have forgotten...
Oi! I'm talking... Can you do it?
With the you expect...
I'm sorry. Too much to do. Try somewhere else.
You got a nerve, you little rat!
The man moves menacingly close, his hand on his sword, when the man with grey eyes holds him back.
Not here.
The angry mercenary glares briefly at his leader before stomping out of the forge.
I thank you for your help, Mr. Dwarf. Perhaps we'll meet again.
The men leave the workshop. You ignore the horsemen and concentrate on your work. When you tell the twins about your visitors later on, they know exactly who you're talking about. You spend the night in the smith's house and continue on your way with your well. The colourful...
Farewell, racket.
You arrive. A do the man's...
I could help you, but compared to human standards, I'm a master smith, so my services will cost you more.
The smith gulps.
More? How much?
Double. My services should be worth that.
Anger and indignation are written across the man's face.
That's much too much. I could have the smith in the neighbouring village do my work for cheaper. I won't pay more than I offered. Take it or leave it.
You say goodbye and leave. After only a few steps, the resigned voice of the smith calls you back.
All right. Double.
A little later, you are standing in the workshop, examining the smith's inferior tools, while he fires up the forge and prepares everything for the job, as well as he can, with just one good arm. You weren't able to persuade the twins to help you. As warriors, they'd rather go hunting, Boindil declared. But you think it's more probable. Hours later, you have...
Wait, can you do...
With the four, you expect them...
These two need...
You can't... While you're... You play it...
So...
Some...
Got lots...
We can't...
The men join a larger group of horsemen. More than a dozen.
Not here in the village. Go. Search the road between here and Clintyre again.
The other mercenaries nod and the group rides off. You can't make head nor tail of what's going on here. You tell the twins about your encounter, and they decide to be especially vigilant over... In the early evening, you make an unusual discovery on the side of the road. A colourful trader's wagon has been carelessly abandoned, with not a soul in sight. You immediately recognise the wagon.
That's Mort's wagon.
I don't like the look of this one bit, Boindil. You take a look around there, I'll stay on this side. Tungdil, you check the surrounding area, and be careful.
You scan the road and the woods on both sides. Apart from the twins, who are fighting their way through the undergrowth within earshot, you can't hear or see anyone. The wagon itself isn't damaged, nor is the drawbar. But the belts and leashes that normally hold the draft animals have been cut clean through. You can see a lot of tracks in the mud around the wagon. Hoof prints and footprints from humans in heavy boots. At least half a dozen long ones must have approached the wagon from the woods on both sides. The dwindling daylight provides little light inside the wagon. It smells of leather, spices, and candles. And there's another smell in the air, which you can't quite place. It reminds you of your forge in Lot Yonan's vaults, but different. It is messy, but no more so than you would expect from a single dwarf. The bed is rumpled, and there are tools and leftover materials piled up on the little workbench. There are several cupboards hanging on the right-hand wall. At the end of the wagon, there's a large wardrobe, and next to the door on the left is a heavy wooden chest with rusty metal hinges. As you try to lift the lid of the chest, you realize that the lock has been broken out of the wood. You open the lid, and look inside. Amongst clothes and some empty boxes, you find a loot case and a beautiful loot of the kind that humans build, as well as a bag of bread and cured meat. You take the loot. You can't play, but an instrument like this is worth good gold. You take the bread and the cured meat. The extra provisions should keep you going for a few days. The smaller cupboards are piled high with a multitude of tins and boxes, all filled with odds and ends that the trader offered for sale to customers on his trips. Nothing of real interest. You reach for the knob of the wardrobe and then stop. The rug in front of the wardrobe squelches as you step on it, as if you had stepped in a puddle. You try to work out what has soaked the rug, when suddenly the door of the wardrobe springs open and something bounces into you. You take a step back, and the realization of what hit you makes you take two more. Lying on the floor in front of you is the body of a dwarf, headless. The head has been cut clean from the neck, but the dwarf's clothes leave you in no doubt that this is Mort, the trader. You take a couple of deep breaths. His head has been cut off cleanly, probably with a sharp blade. A quick glance in the wardrobe confirms what you already suspect. The dwarf's head is nowhere to be seen. You give a short, sharp whistle, and the twins come running at the double. You tell them what you found.
A group of horsemen with heavy boots has been here. And I found Mort in the wagon. Beheaded. I have a hunch that the mercenaries from Fallowrock have something to do with this.
Wretched dwarf killers!
You can tell that Boindil wants revenge and can understand his feelings well. You wrap the body in linen, dig a hole in the woods, and place the body in it. You lay a couple of his tools and other personal belongings you found in the wagon next to him. You wish there was more you could do for him. You continue on your journey in gloomy spirits. You come across an orchard next to a farmstead and surrounded by several fields of wheat. You don't see anyone working in the fields, but there's a young man lying under an apple tree. He has his legs crossed and a straw hat is covering his face.
Excuse me, but we're looking for a group of mercenaries. Have they passed by here?
The young man is startled. He must have nodded off. He looks around anxiously. When he sees you, the fear disappears from his face and is replaced by curiosity. It seems to you that the man is sizing you up.
And if I answer, what's in it for me?
If you can't help us, we'd be happy to ask the owner of the farmstead. We'll just tell him that the man sleeping in the shade of the orchard sent us. What do you think?
The man seems to size you up, and then a crooked smile spreads across his face.
All right, you caught me. The people rode northwest. But please don't tell Father Mullen.
There's no reason for that if you told the truth. So, northwest, you say?
You continue on your journey, while the lazy labourer sinks back into the grass. The first thing you notice as you enter the village of Clintal is how quiet it is. There is hardly a soul in the streets, and the few people you do see immediately disappear into their houses as you get closer. Boindil draws his axes, and Boendal his raven's beak.
Something's not quite right here. Be alert!
You walk on until you reach the village square. Without a word, men enter the square from the left and the right, cutting off your way. You recognize the leader of the group of mercenaries, looking you over with a satisfied expression. Standing next to him is a frail man with graying hair, who doesn't seem able to cope with the situation. He tries several times to say something, but can't find the right words.
Are you going to kill us just like you killed the travelling trader?
The leader of the mercenaries shakes his head sadly and seems shaken.
You fiends want to lay the blame on us? You damn murderers!
Murderers? Come here, dwarf killer!
Are you denying your terrible deed? You were seen murdering poor old Mort, one of your kind in cold blood.
The old man points unnecessarily to the leader of the mercenaries.
So apparently, you saw us committing murder, but you didn't intervene. And then you overtook us and only set a trap for us now and here, several days' journey from the place where it happened. Your story doesn't seem to make much sense.
We knew that the good people of Clintal would stand by us in confronting you. Mort was well known and respected around here.
But how did you know that we would come to Clintal of all places? If you were really tracking us, that wouldn't have been possible. But if you, on the other hand, were the ones being tracked, then it would have been easy for you to steer us into this trap.
He does have a point, Medoran. Why did you?
The village elder stops mid-sentence as the leader of the mercenaries draws his sword. The village elder turns from the mercenary to look at you and then gives his men a signal to withdraw.
Watch out for the archers.
Yes! Of course!
Yes? As good as done!
Huh? On my way.
Huh? I'm with you!
Huh?
Yes? Understood.
Yes? What is it?
Yeah! Huh?
Oh, what bad luck for you!
At what?
At what now? Yes? What is it?
Yes?
For Vrakus!
Yeah! Huh? Yes, yes! Ha-ha!
Say goodbye forever!
And what now?
I didn't hit you very hard!
Ha-ha!
What is it? All right!
Huh? On my way.
What is it? I'm with you! Yes, yes! I'm with you! Yes, yes! I'm with you! Of course! Yes, yes! Of course! Yes, yes! Of course! Yes, yes! Of course! Yes, yes!
Uh-huh.
Attack!
Yes!
Huh? I'm with you! Of course!
What is it? As good as done!
Huh?
End it!
And what now? I'm with you!
Kill him!
Of course!
Huh? What bad luck
Attack!
For you!
Huh? Yes, yes! I'm with you!
I didn't hit you very hard!
Yes, yes!
Huh? For Vrakus!
Yes! With pleasure! Ho-ho! What bad
Who's
luck
next?
For you!
I'm with you! Of course! I'm with you!
Huh? On my way!
And what now? Yes, yes! I'm with you!
What is it? As good as done!
Yes?
Huh? Yes, yes!
Uh-huh.
Huh?
Yeah!
Huh?
What is it?
With pleasure.
And what now? I'm with you!
Huh? Say goodbye forever!
Yeah!
End it!
What is it? Huzzah!
Yes? On my way!
Huh?
The last of the mercenaries falls to the ground, but Boindil is still in the frenzy of battle. You and Boindil have to physically restrain him until he comes to his senses. Otherwise, you'd have stormed the houses to find more adversaries. You walk up to the body of the mercenaries' leader and search his pockets. You soon find something. A letter.
An anonymous client seeks dwarf skulls cleanly cut, shorn, and put into jars with honey. 1,000 gold coins will be paid for each skull. Khan, Bounty Hunter's Guild Master.
That's a... Bounty Hunters. Hunting for dwarves. Despicable.
You hold the letter aloft so that everyone can see it.
Look, citizens of Klintel, proof that these men are the killers. They are bounty hunters hunting for dwarves.
The village elder comes out of one of the houses, flanked by other villagers. You ignore their weapons, as well as their sinister expressions, and hand over the letter.
It would seem you are telling the truth, and you only killed those who deceived us. I thank you for this.
The village elder signals to a woman, and a few moments later, she brings you food and a bag of gold.
Take this in thanks for your actions.
You approach the village and can tell, even from far off, that something isn't right. The smell of burnt wood and death is in the air.
By Vrakus.
The piggies have really shown those pointy ears. We couldn't have done it any better.
Stay alert. I want to find out what happened to Guren.
The elf maiden's graceful snow-white face still radiates beauty, in terrible contrast to the rest of her appearance. From the neck down, she is nothing more than a blood-red, damp and glistening skeleton. There are long nails sticking through her thin bones, and where her beautiful eyes once were are now gaping black holes.
Hoofprints burned into the ground.
How far?
The fire in Boindil's eyes flares up with delight.
Huzzah! That would make a change from those stupid piggies. Did you hear that, brother? We might get to test our blades on Tion's pointy ears.
The hand that painted this picture was that of a master. It is composed exclusively in shades of red, but every single little detail is painstakingly and precisely reflected. Trees, the remains of buildings, bodies. You hesitate.
This picture portrays the village in its state of ruin.
Examining the canvas more closely, you realize that it is actually made of skin. And the red paint seems more than suspicious now. The smell of the smoke has accompanied you for a while now, but here, so close to the bodies, it is masked by the sweet smell of death. You have a bitter taste in your mouth and have to pull yourself together to avoid vomiting in disgust.
This is the most disgusting thing I have ever seen.
You have read about the elves and their buildings. This here had always just been a small example of their architectural skill, which achieved perfection in Alandur. Now burning and ruined, the pavilion makes an even sadder impression. Green Glade was one of the few places in Girdlegard where humans and elves lived together. You don't see any elven features among all the faces contorted with pain and fear. You look away.
Thank you.
The body of the man is riddled with arrows and is lying in a small patch of undamaged ground, while a sea of flames must have raged in a circle around him. The robes remind you of those of Lotjonan's famuli. This, plus the fact that the man used magic, makes you quite sure that this is Garen.
Garen had these books on him when he was attacked. Was he trying to bring them to safety?
Your eyes fall upon a sealed letter next to the books. The circumstances seem grave enough for you to break the seal.
Greetings, Tugga. I am glad to hear that you finally wish to confide in Lotjonan. I have found out something new about the demon. It's all written in these books. I think they are the key to his destruction, or I hope so, at least. Yours faithfully, Garen. What demon are they talking about?
You instinctively think about how the magical barrier is only a few days' march north of here, and beyond it, Varrakis only knows what kind of creatures live in the Perish Land.
You destroyed my painting. Now I need fresh blood to paint a new one.
Huzzah! This will be fun! We finally get to fight!
I hope your blood doesn't clot too much. It has to be nice and fluid for my fine brushstrokes.
Ha! How do you plan to defeat us, Pointy Ears? There are three of us.
Oh, only three. That makes it easier.
She looks over the corpses.
Othar and Lueth Buanre!
What's happening?
That's the Perished Land.
Impossible. Greenglade is south of the barrier.
I know of nothing else that can resurrect the dead. Knock their heads off or they'll keep coming back.
Uh-huh.
Yes, right. Yes!
On my way! Pow! Another one bites the dust! All right!
As good as done!
Yes?
What is it?
Huh? All right! As good as done! On my way!
Huh?
Of course!
Huh?
What is it?
All right! As good as done!
Say goodbye forever!
As good as done!
What is it? I'm with you!
Yes.
And what now? Come here, you!
Huh?
Yes?
Yeah!
Pow! Another one bites the dust!
Yes?
Go easy!
Varrakis!
What is it?
Pleasure.
End it. Kill.
Pow! Another one bites the dust. Say goodbye forever.
He hardly put up a fight.
Huh? Varrakis!
Vile creature.
What is it? What is it?
Ha-ha! Who's next?
Huh?
Yeah! And what now?
I didn't hit you very hard!
He hardly put up a fight!
Huh?
A tart!
And again! Huh?
Huh? Huzzah! Of course!
Huh?
Yeah!
On my way! End it!
Yeah!
What is it?
And what now?
Wild creature!
Ha ha!
And again!
Yes, yes!
Yes? Fabricus,
huh? Oh, what bad luck for you! Say goodbye forever! Come here, you!
Attack!
Too easy! Yes? With pleasure!
Huh?
He hardly put up a fight!
Another one bites the dust!
Ha ha! Huzzah! Yes.
End it!
What is it? Say goodbye forever!
What is it?
Ha ha! Huzzah!
Huh?
Huh?
Yes? At once. Understood.
Attack!
What is it?
Huh? Huh?
Yeah! Yes? With pleasure.
What is it? Yes? On my way.
Huh? Yeah! Too easy!
Dwarves, you protected the glade. The parish.
You can feel your stomach cramping. Unlike Boindil, you can't say a word.
The damn mage, I only had one job!
So this is what it is like to rise from the dead. I feel nothing. I am left with nothing. My love, my beauty, my home, and my forest. Everything has been taken from me. I beg you, have mercy and put an end to my suffering.
Without even being able to look into her eyes, you recognize the sadness in the elf maiden's expression. The dignity that she must once have radiated can only be imagined in her current state.
Karen was here, and I've heard that you elves have special abilities in battle. Did the Alphar take you by surprise in your sleep?
Huh?
On my way!
Yes?
What is it? And what now? Come here, you!
Yes?
Oh, what bad luck for you!
End it!
Huh? Oh, yeah, I hit you very hard!
Huh? Vavrakis!
And what now?
Yes?
What is it? With pleasure. What is it?
And again!
Huh? Understood. On my way.
Yes!
Yes?
Attack!
Huh?
Huh?
End it!
At once. Vavrakis!
Huh?
Kill!
What is it?
Yes?
What is it? Oh, what bad luck for you! Pow! And what
now? Another one bites the dust.
Wild creature.
Huh?
Huh?
Huh? Huh?
End it!
What is it? Say goodbye forever!
Attack!
Yes? What is it? Oh, he didn't hit you very hard!
Of course!
And again!
What is it?
As good as done,
huh? Yes?
Vavrakis,
huh?
Here we go.
Uh-huh.
On my way.
End it. Not again. What is it? What is it? Oh, he didn't hit you very hard!
Yes?
Yes? With pleasure! And what now?
Huh?
Attack!
Vile creature!
Killed!
What is it? What is it? Come here, you!
Huh?
Who's next?
Pow!
Another one bites the dust!
Huh? Say goodbye forever!
On my way!
And what now?
Huh?
Yes? What is it? What is it? Oh, what
and
bad
what
luck
now?
For you!
At once.
Yeah! Oh, he didn't hit you very hard!
Attack!
Too easy!
Huh?
Huh?
Vile creature! And what now?
Vavrakis!
Yeah!
End it!
I didn't hit you very hard! Say goodbye forever!
Killed!
What is it?
As good as done!
Another one bites the dust.
And what now?
On my way. Understood.
Huh?
Ha ha! Huh? On my way.
Huh?
And again.
Oh, what bad luck for you!
Yes, at once.
What is it? I'm with you!
Ha ha! I didn't hit you very hard! Come here, you!
I'm with you! Huzzah!
Uh-huh.
As good as done!
Huh?
What is it?
Huh?
Yeah! And what now?
Uh-huh.
Yes!
Yeah!
All right!
Dwarves, you protected the glade. The perished land, the barrier has fallen.
You can feel your stomach cramping. Unlike Boindil, you can't say a word.
The damn mage, I only had one job!
So this is what it is like to rise from the dead. I feel nothing. I am left with nothing. My love, my beauty, my home, and my forest. Everything has been taken from me. I beg you, have mercy and put an end to my suffering.
Without even being able to look into her eyes, you recognize the sadness in the elf maiden's expression. The dignity that she must once have radiated can only be imagined in her current state.
Karen was here, and I've heard that you elves have special abilities in battle. Did the Alphar take you by surprise in your sleep?
I felt her presence, but when I confronted the elf, she had already killed the first of us and resurrected the perished land. It fills humans and dwarves with a hatred for life. It turns you into beasts. They charge through the village like a fury, and everyone that they killed became one of theirs.
If the perished land spreads further south, then Nodon won't need any orcs, ogres, or Alphar. One human losing their life in the perished land would be enough for the madness to sweep through the land like the plague.
Your stomach turns, but you know that it's right. You've never seen the twins looking so serious. They would pit themselves against any army of orcs, but this is something beyond their power and yours.
We need the Magi. They must rebuild the barrier. I can't believe it. The barrier has fallen. How could that happen?
Who could tell? Anything could go wrong with all that hocus pocus.
It had held back the perished land since the fall of the Fifthlings. Reinforcing the barrier whenever it loses power is the primary duty of the Great Mage. I can't imagine how Nodon or anyone else could have broken through it.
You think of the demons mentioned in Garen's letter. You wonder whether it could be possible that a demon from the Outer Lands might possess powers so great that even the six Magi weren't ready for it.
We must go to Lotjonan before the Perished Land spreads further. Maybe he's still in Perista.
Neither of your companions objects. Every evening since you left Greenglade, you have looked at Goren's books and tried to prize out the knowledge that they hold. But now, you must admit to yourself that you can't decipher them. They are written in the learned language for High Magi, and Lot Yonan didn't teach you that. However, you're sure that the books are important. Why else would Goren want them sent to Turga the Fair-Faced? You put them away with a sigh, and your eyes remain on the bag that Lot Yonan gave you. Did Goren ask Lot Yonan to return the magical artifacts in the pouch? You pick up the pouch and look at it.
Lot Yonan forbade me from opening the pouch.
The hamlet of Sungird certainly lives up to its name. You arrive as the sun sets behind the tower of a Palandiel temple. There's a Every evening since you left Greenglade, you have looked at Goren's books and tried to prize out the knowledge that they hold. But now, you must admit to yourself that you can't decipher them. They are written in the learned language for High Magi, and Lot Yonan didn't teach you that. However, you're sure that the books are important. Why else would Goren want them sent to Turga the Fair-Faced? You put them away with a sigh, and your eyes remain on the bag that Lot Yonan gave you. Did Goren ask Lot Yonan to return the magical artifacts in the pouch? You pick up the pouch and look at it.
Lot Yonan forbade me from opening the pouch.
What the heck? Goren is dead, and you want to know what you're lugging around with you through the length and breadth of Girdlegard. You grasp at the pouch with an uninvolved expression so that the twins don't think you're acting against Lot Yonan's instructions. You undo the knot with nimble fingers. A piercing, bone-splitting sound rings out, and small spheres of light shoot into the air, ending in colorful explosions.
By Frakkus' hammer and all the fires of his forge!
The twins jump up immediately and draw their weapons. You curse and quickly close the pouch again.
By the mountains of Girdlegard! What was that, scholar?
I just wanted to examine the magical trap. It's for thieves, in case someone tries to steal the pouch.
You try to act normally, so that they don't realize you got just as much a shock as they did. Boindil looks at the pouch with animosity.
Magical frippery.
The twins sit down again, and you slowly recover. Just like previous nights, you are haunted by the image of the elf maiden nailed to the tree in Greenglade. You wake from your sleep and look around you. The night is unusually dark. Despite your good dwarven eyes, you can only make out Boindil's outline, even though he's keeping watch only a few steps away. You're about to lie down again, but suddenly feel something cold against your throat. Next to you, the pale face of an elf slides into view.
Good evening. I'm afraid we missed each other in Greenglade, so my companion had to receive you on her own.
You consider your options, but before you have reached a decision, the dagger is pressed more tightly against your throat, and you feel a second blade at your back.
Quiet now. I'm not going to kill you. Not yet. Do you know what I'm going to do instead?
You feverishly search for an answer, but you can't even imagine how an Alphar thinks.
I will kill everyone who means anything to you. I will destroy your life, and you will sink into hopelessness, groundling. Your downfall is called Synthoras.
You tense your muscles, readying to defend yourself, but suddenly realize that the blade against your throat has disappeared. You look around, astonished. The Alf is nowhere to be seen. You look over to Boendal, who is easy to recognize in the bright moonlight. Next to you, Boindil smacks his lips in his sleep. You touch your throat, and when you don't feel anything, you breathe out, relieved.
Just a nightmare.
At least that's what you tell yourself. But you don't close your eyes for the rest of the night. The hamlet of Sungird certainly lives up to its name. You arrive as the sun sets behind the tower of a Palandiel temple, lighting up its stained glass. There's a shop in the village, and through the window, as well, a small bell rings as you enter the shop. The twins look around, but seem rather disinterested, until they discover a couple of gemstones on display. Boindil unwraps his dwarf cheese again and cooks it on the fire. When he offers you a piece, you take it.
I knew we'd make a dwarf of you in the end.
You chew on the cheese so you don't have to answer. It tastes better than you first thought. You reach Parista and go straight to the seat of the Council of Magi. A worried and grim-looking guard bars your way.
Sorry, we are not to let anyone into the palace.
The guard looks around nervously.
Lightning bolts. A couple of days ago. Not like in a storm, but in all the colours of the rainbow. On the next day, we were told that the Magi had all departed again, and Master Nudin was not to be disturbed. No one has been allowed in the palace since then. Not even us.
The report of lightning bolts doesn't particularly worry you. On the contrary. If the Magi have travelled back to their kingdoms, it can only mean that they were able to reinforce the barrier. You are eager to hear Lot Yonan's account in the vaults.
So we meet again, dear dwarf. Tungdil, wasn't it? Interested in buying something?
You say goodbye to the traders and continue your journey. Once again, you reach the crossroads and the Stone Sheep Tavern. You walk to the nearest empty table with the twins in tow and sit down. The landlord comes out from behind the bar and walks over to your table. He gives a narrow smile.
Good to see you again. What can I get you today?
Despite Boindil's loud protestations about wanting another drink, you say goodbye and set off on your way accompanied by the twins.
why are the Magus' vaults here in the middle of nowhere? And why does the Lord of Yonandar live in a vault and not in a castle?
It's to do with the magical fields that spread out under Girdlegard. So the five magical realms are found where the fields are at their strongest.
And that's why he lives in the vaults? To be closer to the underground magic?
No, it's more to do with security. 200 students of magic and a source of almost unlimited magical energy. The Magus thought that an underground vault was a more suitable place to train than Master Nudin's tower in the middle of Perista.
I don't like it here. All this hocus-pocus is bad news. Us dwarves know that and keep well away, just as Vrakas commanded. I hope you know that too.
I cannot perform magic, and I've never attempted to. Nevertheless, please show respect. Remember that it was Lot-Yonan who took me in and saved me.
Now then, it would seem that the tongue of the learned one becomes somewhat haughtier, and his sentences doth wind most strangely as we verily approach the vaults.
You can't help but grin guiltily. With a beseeching glance at the twins, you step into the area in front of the vaults. Seeing no one there you might greet, you and your companions enter your old home through the open gate.
Built this tunnel.
Bowendal examines the crumbling roof with a mixture of disbelief and indignation.
Be quiet. I want to surprise them.
Is that such a good idea? What if we give your master such a shock that he casts a spell on us? I don't want to be turned into a mouse or a bar of soap.
It is unusually quiet in the vaults, but the smell of dinner is in the air. You imagine Frala looking up at you from her cooking pot in the kitchen and smiling.
Ah, there's boiled and roasted meat for dinner. Come on.
That's no reason to go and get ourselves turned into something weird. We'll stay here until you're finished with your little game. Only Longuns will build like this. They've cut through the strata with no concern for the veins. That's obvious, even to a warrior like me.
Ah, the warmth has dried out the strata and made them all crumbly. Even the wooden beams won't hold the roof up for much longer.
Tungdil, have you found your Magus yet?
No, not yet. I'll keep looking.
Your workshop seems smaller than you remember it. You are also sure that it smells different than when you set off months ago.
A couple of weeks ago, this anvil was my whole world. Now my world's a whole lot bigger.
Ikana isn't in her cradle. Where could Frala have taken her? Lumps of meat rise up and appear on the brown, bubbling surface of the soup before sinking back down out of sight. The hearty smell makes your mouth water.
Oh. A human foot?
Your stomach turns, and you have to fight hard against the impulse to run out of the kitchen screaming.
Only long'uns will build like this. They've cut through this.
Ah, the warmth has dried out the
Tondo, have you found your magus yet?
You don't want to bother them with your gruesome find until you know what's happened here. Either way, there's no harm in having two strong warriors guard the gate.
No, not yet. I'll keep looking. What happened here? Speak!
Ah, another one.
Don't even think of using magic, or I'll lodge this pretty piece of steel in your brain.
It takes the Famulus a few seconds to comprehend the situation he suddenly found himself in. He seems to weigh up his options for a moment before he breathes out and the tension leaves his body.
All right, I won't use magic.
What happened here? Where is everyone?
For a while, the Famulus seems to be playing with the idea of being stubborn. Bowendal pushes a little harder on the end of the crow's beak, and the tip penetrates the skin. Blood seeps out.
Ah! Ah! They're gone! Dead!
A school full of magi destroyed without any signs of struggle? Lies!
The facts seem stacked against it, but you cling on to this faint hope.
Lot Yonan's famuli were already in Parista. There are only novices left. We made easy work of them. The Elfar, Syntharas, he insisted on being part of the raid after he found out that you grew up here. He opened the gates and killed most of those here before they even knew what was happening.
In your mind's eye, you see a pale face appearing from the darkness. You saw what Elfar are capable of in Greenglade. You push the thought to the back of your mind and try to keep a clear head.
Lot Yonan, where is he?
Nodon killed him. He killed all of them in Parista. There's no one left in Girdlegard who can take on the last Magus.
You're saying that someone took on all six of the Magi at once and defeated them? Ridiculous.
Five Magi. My master Nudin is Nodon the Doublefold, the Lord of the Perished Land and soon to be Lord of Girdlegard. He killed the masters, and the apprentices followed soon after. They're all gone, and he changed the magic field so that only we can use them.
An icy hand grabs your heart. It's impossible that there's only a single Magus left, and he's not fighting against, but for the Perished Land.
Why are you snooping around in Lot Yonan's study? What are you looking for?
I'm looking for artifacts that Lot Yonan, when he was in Parista, claimed he had forgotten and left in a cupboard, and for the books that were stolen from Greenglade. I'm guessing you're the dwarves that stole the books.
What does your master want with the artifacts and the books?
I don't know. He commands, we obey. He's going to be very displeased. I did find a bag in the cupboard, but it didn't contain the right objects.
I've had enough of your lies. They're alive. Lot Yonan escaped and has gathered his apprentices, Frala, and the others around him to fight against Nodon. We just have to find them.
The war was over before you even noticed it had begun. Nodon cannot be stopped. He is on his way here and will just...
Blah, blah. We will leave immediately. This news is of great importance to the Council of Dwarves.
I'm not going anywhere. I have to find my friends and I...
Orcs! Lots of them!
Huh?
As good as done!
Yes? Understood.
Huh? All right.
Huh?
What is it?
Huh? On my way.
What is it?
And what now? Yes, yes. Of course.
Huh? At once.
Who's next?
I didn't hit you very hard. Yes? Pow! Another one bites the dust. With pleasure.
Huh? Yes. Attack!
And again. Too easy! On my way!
And what now?
Come here, you! Who's next? Huh?
Uh-huh.
Yeah! What is it?
Too easy! Yes?
Huh? Huh?
Yeah!
Huh?
And what now?
Another one bites the dust!
I'm with you!
Uh-huh.
Yeah!
Yes? Say goodbye forever!
Huzzah! Ha ha!
Too easy!
Yes?
What is it?
Can't he put up a fight? What is it?
Huh?
And what now?
For Vrakus!
I didn't hit you very hard! Yes?
What is it?
What is it?
And what now?
Huh?
Huh?
What is it?
Yeah! And what now?
And again. Huh? All right.
Huh?
Yes, yes. Huzzah!
Yes. As good as done. Oh, what bad luck for
and
you!
And what now?
Vile creature! End it! There are too many of them!
The side door in the workshop. It's our only chance.
Who's next?
What is it?
Huh?
I'm with you!
Another one bites the dust.
Yes?
Yeah!
We hardly put up a fight.
Huh?
say goodbye forever!
Ha ha! What is it? Ha ha!
Huh?
Yes?
Vile creature!
Huh? Yes, yes!
Here,
too easy!
Put up a fight! Yes?
Huh?
What now? Come here, you! Who's next?
Huh?
Yes?
You.
What is it?
What is it?
Huh?
Yes?
Huh? Huzzah!
Too easy!
Huh?
What is it?
What is it?
Uh-huh. Understood.
Yes?
And what now?
Yeah!
Huh?
What is it?
I'm with you.
Yes, yes.
And again. Yes? Favrakis!
Yes?
Of course!
Yeah!
Huh?
Huh? As good as done!
On my way.
Who's next?
Yes?
Oh, I'm going to go!
Yes? On my way! As good as done! On my way!
And what now? Of course! Yes, yes! Of course! Yes, yes! I'm with you!
Huh? On my way.
What is it? As good as done! On my way! As good as done!
Damn.
The first 20 are mine!
You have come far, but this is far enough. Give me the artifacts and the books you stole in Greenglade, and I'll set you free.
What's with the artifacts and the books?
They belong to me. Lotionan was supposed to bring them to Porista, but forgot them. So, I came to pick them up.
That's all you need to know.
What have you done to the other Magi? Your Famulus told us some cock and bull story about you forcing them and their Famuli to go to Perista and then murdering them.
I did what had to be done to protect Girdle Guard. I wish there had been another way. But they would never have understood.
Do your eyes deceive you, or do you really see a brief moment of real regret on the swollen face of the Magus?
You wanting my rucksack is enough reason for me not to give it to you.
I don't need your consent. Look after the rucksack. If you lose it, you will also lose your life. Go back to your realm, dwarves, and let your king know that I need his land. Either he hands it over without a drop of blood being spilt, or my troops and allies take it by force. You can take this one with you. I have no use for him.
Invisible wizard, Maya!
Look!
Let me handle her. Kill the dwarves!
The rucksack! The artifacts! If he wants them so badly, they might be the key to his destruction.
There's the orc with the rucksack! Let's get him!
And I didn't even take off my gloves.
Yes?
I didn't hit you very hard!
Attack!
And what now?
Vile creature!
Who's next?
Attack!
What is it?
Yes?
Huh?
All right. I'll be ready soon.
What is it?
For Vrakus.
End it.
What is it?
All right. As good as done.
What bad luck for
and
you.
And what now?
Of course.
Yes?
Yeah!
I didn't hit you very hard.
No all right. Chance.
Yes?
Yes! Of course!
What is it? As good as done!
Understood.
And what now?
Yes. With pleasure.
Pow!
Another one bites the dust. All right.
I can't do that yet.
What is it?
Yes? At once.
And what? Huh? Now!
As good as done! Don't rush me! Oh,
what the fight!
As good as done! On my way!
What is it?
Yes?
Huh?
What a waste of time.
And what now? Yes, yes! Huzzah!
Huh?
And I didn't even take
off
my
mask. How many more of them are there?
Fabricus!
What is it?
I find it!
The Peggy!
Do your axes over here! As good as done!
Huh? At once.
Attack!
Understood.
He hardly put up a fight.
At once.
And what now?
Yes?
Uh-huh.
End it.
What is it? On my way.
Yes?
Yeah!
Huh?
Yes, yes, so.
No chance.
Huh?
Huh?
Favrakis.
Attack! At once.
Favrakis!
Yeah! On my way.
What a waste of time. Attack!
And I didn't even take off my gloves.
What is it?
Yes? As good as done.
On my way.
Yes, yes!
What is it?
Yes.
And what now?
On my way!
Ha ha! Fabricus!
Understood.
Yeah!
On my way.
Too easy!
Huh?
Yes?
Didn't take off my gloves.
Oh, what bad luck
yes.
for you! What is it?
What is it? As good as done. With pleasure.
Huh?
What a waste of time.
Huh?
I didn't hit you very hard! Yes? Say goodbye
yes.
forever!
And what now?
Huzzah!
Who's next?
Ha ha!
Huh?
Uh-huh.
What is it?
Yes? With pleasure!
What a waste of time.
Yes?
Yeah!
Huh?
I'm not that quick!
What is it? On my way!
What is it? Yes, yes,
yes! As good as done!
Oh, what bad luck for you!
Say goodbye forever!
Huh?
What is it? Pleasure.
Yes.
Vile creature.
Favrakis.
And what now?
Huh?
And again.
Oh, what bad luck for you.
Yes? With pleasure.
Yeah.
Too easy! Say goodbye forever!
And what now?
Huzzah!
What is it?
And I didn't even take off my gloves.
Yes?
Yes?
What is it?
What is it? With pleasure.
I'm with you.
Pow! Another one bites the dust.
Huzzah!
Yes.
And what now?
All right.
Ha-ha.
Oh, what bad luck for you! I'll be ready soon.
No chance.
On my way.
Attack! Understood.
Who's next? And what now?
Yes? As good as done. On my way.
Yes, on my way.
Of course.
As good as done.
What is it?
What is it? Yes?
Oh, what bad luck
Understood.
For you!
End it!
Of course! Yes, yes!
What a waste of time.
I'm with you!
What is it? All right.
Yes, on my way.
And what now? Yes, yes!
Huh?
What is it?
With pleasure.
Attack!
And I didn't even take off my gloves.
Say goodbye forever.
And what now?
Come here, you. Yes? Oh, what bad luck for you.
I won't. End it.
What is it? Huzzah!
No chance.
Of course!
Say goodbye forever!
Attack!
What is it?
I didn't even take off my gloves.
You. Yes? As good as done.
What is it?
What is it? All
right. Of course.
Yes? I've got the rucksack.
Let's get out of here. Over the bridge. On my way. Yes?
Thank you. Yes, yes!
Yes?
Please wait a moment!
What is it? Say goodbye forever!
And what now?
Come here, you!
Yes? All right!
No chance.
What is it?
Too easy!
What is it? As good as done!
And what now?
Yes?
Huh? Yes, yes!
Yes? Yeah. Huh?
On my way!
Understood. Of course!
Uh-huh.
What is it?
What is it?
Let's get out of here!
Retreat? We should fight on!
We would die! Perhaps you've noticed that Nodon has risen again, headless. He is more powerful than the Perish Land itself, but the key to his destruction is in here.
We will return to the Secondlings and tell them what the Magus is up to. We'll be safe at Ogre's death, and there we can hatch a plan.
If we manage to get there, Nodon will do anything to stop us.
Then let him try! That was fun. What's next?
Boindil looks at you, and the sparkle in his eyes goes out.
We are both very sorry about what happened here, Tungdil.
He told me, Cynthra said. I convinced myself that...
You gulp and turn away from your friends.
What I call a goodly challenge. Cover me.
Not a good idea if you want to go on living, dwarf.
You've got quite a big mouth for someone who sounds like a girl.
You are Andikai, the Tempestuous, right?
Correct. And you are Tungdil, Lot Yonan's charge.
Honorable Mager, what news of Lot Yonan? Does he live?
Andikai looks at you in silence, pain and rage slowly spreading across her face.
He is dead, Tungdil, along with Myra, Turga, and Sabora. Nod On killed them all and destroyed the Council of Magi.
The certainty of their death is painful. It feels as though someone has just torn your insides out.
He killed their best pupils, too. And now he's the unchallenged Magus in Girdleguard.
It was you, wasn't it, that attacked them with the lightning? Were you any more successful than we were?
Andikai shakes her head.
He defied everything I threw at him. All of my skills. In vain. I soon realized he was superior to me, but I wanted to buy you some time.
Nodon's Famula said that he had changed the magical fields, but you still seem to be able to use them.
Andikai smiles.
I'm not quite as benevolent as the other Magi. My god Samusin is the god of balance. He loves the darkness as much as the light, which means I can use both. But my powers aren't unlimited. It is difficult for me to store and use this altered magic. We should avoid confrontation as much as possible.
Your companion, won't he sit with us and introduce himself?
Yes! Hey, you up there! Can you even hear us with that bucket on your head?
Jerun is mute, and he won't do you any harm unless I command him to. And as long as you treat him with courtesy, dwarf.
Boindil seems to briefly weigh up his chances against the two of them.
I decide when I'm courteous. Just don't get in my way. And the orcs are mine!
What happened? How could he defeat the Council of Magi?
Nudin called us to Perista, under the guise of reinforcing the barrier against the perished land. Instead, he tricked us, took control of most of our powers and attacked us. I cut him down with my sword, but he rose again and impaled me with his staff. All I can remember after that is the sound of fighting, destruction, and cries of death.
How did you survive?
Jerun. Nudin had forgotten he was with me in Perista. He found me, tended to my wounds and brought me out of the city to safety until I could summon up enough power to heal myself.
And Lot Yonan?
When Jerun carried me away, he was frozen in stone, like a statue. To my knowledge, the spell cannot be reversed.
You nod slowly. You don't have the strength to say anything else right now.
What will you do now?
Leave this place. I'm not so foolish as to believe that I could restrain the perished land or nod on. Why should I stay here?
Foolish, no. But cowardly.
You're on your way to the kingdom of the Secondlings, right? Then I will accompany you and leave Girdlegard by the High Pass.
We'll need all the help we can get. Nodon will have a lot worse in store for us than just orcs.
The Maegar nods in agreement. Then she looks pensively at your rucksack.
Your rucksack? Why did Nodon want it?
I was taking some objects to Goren, one of Lot Yonan's famuli. He was murdered at Greenglade by an Alf. There were books lying next to his body, which he was planning to send to Turga the Fairfaced.
May I see them?
You nod. Take the books out of your rucksack and hand them to her. She goes through the letter and the books, one after another, without showing any sign of emotion. Finally, she closes the last of the books.
Is that all? They are only sagas and travelogues from the Outer Lands, which tell of legendary creatures and myths. I don't know why they should be of interest to Nodon.
There must be something in them that's important to him. He destroyed a whole village for them, and the vaults.
Possibly. I'll study the books. But let's sleep now. Jerun can keep watch. We are still being followed.
The path leads you through a ravine whose steep walls are mainly made up of loose boulders and scree. You could probably cause a rockfall that would block your pursuer's path and obstruct your way back. It takes longer than you would have liked to trigger a rockfall that is big enough, but when the dust settles, you realize that you have been rewarded for your troubles. The path is blocked. The army is too big for you, and even if you could defeat them, the battle would take up too much time. So you decide to march through the night to increase the distance between you and them. The forced march is strenuous, but you manage to evade the Horde. You have put out a plate of food for the night every evening and
you're in dis-
It would seem that one of the armies who've been following you since Lot Yonan's vaults has caught up with you. You can even smell the rancid grease the orcs use on their weapons. Boindil immediately prepares to fight, but Andukai demands you avoid confrontation. It would seem that one of the armies who've been following you since In the afternoon, with the sun low in the sky, the path leads you through a ravine. A glance at your map suggests that you're near to Boribor, the Orc realm.
Fracas, may we remain unscathed.
About a mile further on, Boindil suddenly stops in his tracks and sniffs.
Can you smell that? Piggy snouts! And lots of them too!
Let's proceed with caution. Perhaps we can take a few of them out before they raise the alarm.
Yes, right, yes!
If I have to.
And what now? I'm with you!
Huh? Understood.
What is it?
What is it?
Up there! We have to stop them before they can warn anyone!
Huh? Yes, yes!
Hmm?
Uh-huh.
Now you've got me interested.
Huh? On my way.
And what now?
What is it?
Uh-huh.
Huh? Of course!
What a waste of time.
Yes, yes! Huzzah! Hmm?
Yes?
Yeah! What is it?
Now you've got me interested. With pleasure.
Huh?
End it!
And what now?
Hmm? If I have to. Not a bad idea. Now you've got me interested.
Huh?
What is it? Of course!
What is it? Feel my power!
Yes?
Favrakis!
No chance.
And again! Attack!
Huh? Yes, yes!
Now you've got me interested.
Vile creature!
Not a bad idea.
Yes?
Huh? Come here, you!
Now you've got me interested.
Huh? On my way.
And what now? Huzzah!
What is it? Yeah! All right, then. With pleasure.
Yes?
What is it? I'm with you!
Now you've got me interested. Hmm? Feel my power! And I didn't even take off my gloves. What is it? With pleasure. Feel my power! Ah! Hmm? This is going to hurt. All right, then. If I have to. What is it?
Yes, yes!
Huh? At what?
Idea. If I have to.
Oh, yes, yes.
Hmm?
On my way. Understood. Yes?
What is it?
Yeah!
If I have to.
Ah!
Huh? Huh?
Now you've got me interested. Huh?
We hardly put up a fight!
No chance.
And what now?
What is it?
Yes?
Yeah! What is it? Huzzah!
Now you've got me interested.
Who's next?
Huh?
Huh? I'm waiting out! Huzzah! Come here, you!
Yes?
Yeah!
Avrakis!
Yeah!
What is it?
What is it? Come here, you!
Now you've got me interested.
Huh?
Attack!
No chance.
Killed!
At once.
Yes?
Oh, not a bad idea. What is it?
Huh? Yes, yes!
Hmm?
Huh? Understood.
What is it? Right then. What a waste of time.
What
a bad idea.
Yes?
Hmm? If I have to. All right then. If I have to. Not a bad idea. No chance. All right then. Not a bad idea. Feel my power. If I have to. All right then.
Uh-huh. Understood.
What is it?
What is it?
Yes?
Yeah!
Uh-huh.
Oh, wait, you!
Understood.
Oh, yes, yes! Yes. And what now? Ha ha! Yes, yes! Of course! I'm with you! Come here, you! Yes, yes!
Hmm? If I have to.
Huh?
End it!
Now you've got me interested.
Yeah!
What is it?
Yes?
And what now? We hardly put up a fight!
Now you've got me interested. This is going to hurt.
Who's next?
Wild creature.
Huh?
Yeah!
For Vrakus!
Yeah!
Huh?
Hmm?
Yes?
What is it?
What is it? Not a bad idea. All right, then.
Aye!
If I have to.
Huh?
End it!
And what now?
Yes?
Huh?
Hmm? Not a bad idea.
Huh?
What is it? Huzzah! Oink, oink, little piggies!
Now you've got me interested.
Yes?
What is it?
Uh-huh. Understood. Yes?
And what now?
Hmm?
What is it?
Huh? For Vrakus!
What is it? Now you've got me interested.
Yes?
End it!
What is it?
And I didn't even take off my gloves.
Huh?
Huh? Come here, you!
Hmm? If I have to.
On my way.
Yeah! What is it?
Now you've got me interested. What a waste of time.
Yes.
Attack!
Understood.
End it.
Hmm? This is going to hurt. And I didn't even take off my gloves.
On my way. Huh?
Huh? Ha ha! Yeah! Of course! I'm with you! Of course! What is it?
What is it? Not a bad idea.
Yes?
Yes, yes! And what now? Mm.
If I have to...
We should go down into the caves and vaults. There'll be more of them down there.
Or maybe we should concentrate on finally getting to Ogre's Death Stronghold, Boindil.
You ignore the offended look on your friend's face and set off, leaving the Orc Mountains behind you. You have put out a plate of food for the night every evening since Jerun and Andakai joined you on your journey, but still none of you have seen him eat. You decide to pay particular attention to him this evening to try and find out what is under the helmet. Andakai is sitting not far from the giant, studying the books.
Have you found anything useful yet?
She looks up at you.
You think I will stay and fight if there is a spell in the books that might defeat Nodon?
Yours is the God of Balance. Don't you see it as your duty to create a balance between light and dark?
Instead of answering, Andakai rubs her eyes and closes the books.
It's too dark to study. Let's see what tomorrow brings.
Disgruntled, you watch the Maegar as she walks over to her bed for the night. Your eyes fall upon Jerun and the plate at his feet, on which not a crumb of food is left. You can already see the oasis a day's journey away, but in the glimmer of the midday sun, you're not sure whether it might not just be a mirage. But the twins are convinced that there is a village here, and the prospect of a roof over your heads for the night keeps you going. The nearer you get to the oasis, the more the uneasy feeling grows that something's not right. It's too quiet, and you don't see any movement. Once you enter the village, your fears are confirmed. Your enemies have already been here.
I'm telling you, it's a trap.
If it is, then we'll soon find out.
This whole thing is probably a trap. We should...
Welcome to Pasnar. I'm sure the citizens would greet you themselves, if they could.
You recognize the elf immediately. You saw him with the leaders of the orcs, and he appeared to you in a dream after Greenglade. Or no, not in a dream.
Cintharas.
So we meet again, Tungdil. What do you think of my work in the vaults? It was a nice start, wasn't it?
An eerie smile sets on Cintharas's lips.
Wonderful! I can see the hatred in your eyes. Come on. Come and get your revenge!
What is it? Not a bad idea.
What is it? Come here, you!
On my way.
Yes? As good as done! All right!
Now you've got me interested.
What is it?
Yes?
And what now?
Take off my gloves.
Huh?
Yes?
Huh? I'm not that quick! Yes? With pleasure, huh?
Understood. On my way.
Now you've got me interested.
Oink, oink, little piggies!
No chance.
Yes, yes! What is it?
Yes?
Huh?
And I didn't even take off my gloves.
Huh?
Huh? What is it?
What is it? This is going to hurt. What a waste of time.
Yes?
Yes? On my way!
Huh?
What is it?
Yes?
Huh?
What is it? Then, no chance.
And what now? What is it?
Huh? At once.
What is it?
Yes? Understood.
As good as done!
Now you've got me interested.
Huh? What is it?
What is it?
Huh?
Favrakis!
Yes?
Who are you?
Huh? At once.
End it.
Yeah! What is it? Of course!
Now you've got me interested.
Huh? On my way.
And what now? Huzzah!
Huh? All right. As good as done.
What is it?
What is it?
Now you've got me interested.
My gloves.
Huh?
What is it? Yeah! Huzzah! Yes!
Take it! With pleasure.
What is it?
Yes.
Huh?
Too easy.
Huh? All right.
Pow!
Another one bites the dust.
Now you've got me interested. If I have to.
Uh-huh. Understood. I can't do that yet.
End it.
Please wait a moment.
Yeah! What is it? What is it?
Say goodbye forever.
Pow!
Another one bites the
dust. What is it? All right, then.
Huh?
Huh?
Oh, he didn't hit you very hard! Too easy! Who's next?
Yes?
What is it? Yes!
I'm with you! Another one bites the dust! As good as done! With pleasure!
Now you've got me interested.
Feel my power! What a waste of
time.
And
what now? Yes, soon.
What is it? Say goodbye forever. With pleasure.
What is it?
Pow!
Not a bad one. Points the dust.
What is it?
Huh? say goodbye
now
forever.
You've got me interested.
Too easy.
I can't do that yet.
Yeah. Yeah. And what now? What is it? With pleasure.
What is it?
Huh?
Yeah! Pow! Another one bites the dust!
Attack!
Huh? Yes?
Now you've got me interested. With pleasure.
Understood.
What is it? Of course! Yes?
What a waste of time.
On my way!
Huh?
And what now? Huh?
Hmm?
Yeah! Hey!
Huh? Huh? On my way.
Huh? What is it?
What is it?
Retreat! Back! Why are you here? And how can you possibly still use magic?
The one person your master left living is the one you would least like to have as an enemy. Go on, little Alf. Flee!
Your magic saved you this time. But next time, I'll be prepared.
I've had enough of fighting. It's about time we head to your home.
I've had enough too. But we've got several days in the desert ahead of us before we can enjoy a cold beer.
The longer we talk about it, the later we'll get to our beer. Let's go.
You've been traveling through the desert for days. The sand is simply everywhere. In your shoes, under your clothes, in your mouths. Even the makeshift cloths that you've wrapped around your heads is of little help. With the last of the energy you can muster, you finally leave the 40-mile-wide sandbar that separated you from Ogre's death. It is as if you've passed through an invisible wall when the raging wind and sand suddenly fall silent. In front of you, an enormous massive towers into the sky, the Blue Range. The slopes cast long shadows over Ogre's Death Fortress, which nestles in the spurs of the mountain. Even from this distance it looks impressive, with its four defensive terraces, one above the other. The anticipation of entering a real dwarven city for the first time grows with every step, and you feel the power returning to your limbs. You've almost done it.
My High King, you have called me to succeed you to the throne. Here I stand before you.
Well...
Before you are chosen as the successor to the High King, here, King Gandagar, the challenges that await you. Hordes of orcs are rampaging through the north and the west, and the perished land is stirring. It would seem that the Magi cannot sustain the barriers.
This gives us an excellent opportunity to attack the last elves in Alandur. They are weakened. The perished land afflicts them. Let us wipe out the traitors once and for all.
Yes, right. Exactly.
Hear, hear.
Madness. What are you talking about?
I do not recognize you, King Gandagar, in what you are saying. The elves are inhabitants of Girdlegard. Has your hatred for them clouded your senses to the point that you wish to ignore the words of our god?
Belendalin's gaze falls, as if incidentally, on the King of the Forthlings' advisor.
Or is someone giving you bad advice?
On the contrary, it was Bislipper who finally supplied me with the proof. A report titled, How the Fifthlings Lost the Gate. It was the elves that poisoned the brave Fifthling warriors in their stronghold. A devious disease spread by the pointy ears in the shafts of the Grey Range. Impossible!
I always knew it!
Treason!
I don't believe
that. They should pay for it!
Get the pointy ears!
Enough! Don't be so short-sighted! We are talking about the safety of Girdlegard. We must reach out and forge a large coalition with the elves. Yes? And even with the Thirdlings, if we are to defeat the perished land.
My High King, you cannot be serious.
Drivel from a dwarf who has grown too old in his post. Are we not here to choose a new High King? We have waited long enough.
It would seem you will have to wait a little bit longer. The second aspirant has arrived. Our guests must be tired from their long journey. The meeting is adjourned till tomorrow.
But why do you think that I...
Everything will become clear. I've had a room prepared for you. Before you take to your bed, please pay the High King and I a visit in the throne room.
You can't see the bottom. When the Secondlings named the Blue Range their home, there was nothing here but hard rock and a few small caves. Fantastic.
Your Highness!
Heir apparent? What do you know? Spit it out!
A slight expression of guilt flits briefly across Boindil's face, but he's soon back to his old self.
A scholar as High King has something to it! You'll certainly have our votes, that's for sure.
Boindil nods in agreement.
As High King? You could unite the kingdoms and get them to do battle against Nod-On.
You look at your friends and aren't really sure whether they are trying to pull your leg or not.
I can't be High King. I got all my knowledge from books and you're pulling my leg, right?
The twins' grins grow ever wider, and it would seem they can hardly contain themselves.
Just talk to High King Gundrabur and Belindolin. They will explain everything.
High King Gundrabur seems... well...
old? He is ancient, even by dwarvish standards. He has been old for as long as I can remember. Belindolin has taken care of most matters for dozens of cycles. But Gundrabur always has the final word. His mind is younger than all of ours, I tell ya.
Belindolin should become High King. I was there when a runt took his arm. He still managed to kill half a dozen of them afterwards. What fighting spirit! We had to drag him off the battlefield!
The law requires that a firstling or a fourthling must be chosen as the new king of all dwarves. And... as the firstlings didn't turn up.
For the first time, you have the chance to appreciate the beauty of the place. You suddenly forget what you wanted to say.
I've never seen such masterful masonry. To be honest, I didn't even know that stone could be worked in such a way.
Ha ha ha! The Secondlings are the best masons of all the kingdoms. That's how Fracas made us. Well, he made some of us into warriors, too.
Boindil glances at his brother, and he laughs with satisfaction while looking around the hall himself.
I think I'll continue to look around.
Don't get lost. And tonight, we will finally drink a lovely dark ale in the glowing anvil.
I think I first need to organize my thoughts before I can talk to them.
Tongdil, come closer.
The power that the old High King radiated when he called the assembly to order has drained away from him. His body is sunken in the throne, but his eyes are alert and interested as he looks at you.
The lost son returns to his people. Thank Vrakas. Tell us what you learned on your journey.
You describe your adventure down to the smallest detail. Neither the king nor his advisor interrupts you. From time to time, they nod, as though they were already aware of certain facts. Their brows become more furrowed with every passing minute. When you are finished with your story, You also have some questions.
I don't want to appear ungrateful, and I'm happy to finally be among my people, but I will not ascend the throne. I hardly know anything about our customs and laws. Everything that I know, I have learned from books that Lot Yonan gave me. There must be more suitable heirs than me.
Your announcement honors you, but to be honest, you never had a claim. To stop Gandagar, we had to stall for time.
Lot Yonan helped us with our little story. We don't even know if you are a Fourthling.
The king's advisor misinterprets your unbelieving gaze and quickly adds...
We're only being as deceitful as goblins for one solitary reason. To stave off possible harm to our people.
You feel as though you've been hit in the stomach. If this is true, not only have you lost your newly found kingdom, but Master Lot Yonan also didn't see it as necessary to inaugurate you in the conspiracy.
What game is being played here?
Gandagar as King of the Fourthlings is to supersede me as High King, but his mind is poisoned with hatred towards the elves. He would probably win a war against them, but he would weaken us, and Girdlegard would not be helped by this. I was hoping for a great coalition with the elves, and even with the Thirdlings. I would have given anything to start the negotiations. In times of great need, only the common goal can count.
And which role have you planned for me?
Well, with you as a second aspirant, certain possibilities of protocol open up to us.
Why is Gandagar so full of hatred towards the elves?
His father and brother were murdered by elves. At least that's what's claimed.
No one knows the truth. Just as no one knows how true this report about the Fifthlings is. But isn't it strange that this letter has turned up now, just when it can play into the hands of the elf haters? Many dwarves' hatred towards the elves is great. Perhaps even greater than their honesty.
I understand why you want to prevent a High King Gandagar. You would be blind to our real problems.
Gandagar's only liability is that he lets Bislipper whisper dark thoughts in his ear. The advisor is the problem, not the king.
A problem that I am fortunate enough not to have.
The High King smiles weakly at his advisor.
Gandagar is a good dwarf and a good king, and I am certain he could also be a good High King if he was free of Bislipur's lies and false advice.
Your plan has a flaw. Even if I were to line up, I couldn't win. No one on the council will vote for me.
You don't have to win.
Belendalin points to the Steelies in the throne room.
It's written in our laws that the High King can oppose an heir if he isn't elected unanimously. He can then demand a duel or a contest in order to determine the winner.
Such a contest could take weeks, if not months, and it would win us some time.
What kind of contest would you have us compete in? Gandagar is surely superior to me in many things.
Everyone in the council will write a task on a piece of paper, and from them the contest will be drawn.
And this only once you have made a speech and have won over as many as possible in the council to your side. The more sympathetic the council is towards you, the higher the chances of a contest that fits your abilities.
Speech? You're beginning to like this whole thing less and less.
Is this really the best for our people? If you cannot dissuade Gandagar from carrying out his plans, it could end in a fraternal war.
Don't worry. We'll open up his eyes and he will recognize the malice of his feigned friend. We just need time, and you must gain it for us.
I'm not sure. What if it goes wrong and we split the dwarves into two factions?
We won't let it get that far. But you, Tongdil, will have to help us.
We will support you with all our power. You will not take this road on your own.
All right, then. If you believe in it, I will follow your plan.
No one acts more honorably than you, Tongdil.
Belendalin smiles at you encouragingly.
You say Andakai may have found a way to defeat Nodon. And she suspects that the Magus is possessed by a demon from the Outer Lands. It may be possible to kill this demon with an axe called Keenfire. I have commissioned armor that is worthy of a prince. It will be delivered to your chamber by sunrise.
You say goodbye with a queasy feeling in your stomach. You always thought that you were articulate, but the prospect of having to make a speech in front of the large council doesn't exactly fill you with elation. The High King's advisor has the build of a warrior. His eyes are like those of a bird of prey, and you can see a keen intellect behind them. Even for a dwarf, High King Gundrabur is very old. His long white beard suggests 500 or more cycles. He seems weak, but when you talk to him, you feel an aura of grandeur. Vrakas, who made the dwarves of stone, has himself been hewn from stone by these self-same dwarves. A masterly piece of work, like one of which only the masons of the Secondlings can still accomplish today. You skim over the ornate runes and look for the passage that Gundrabur and Belendalin told you about.
If there is more than one candidate from a kingdom, and none can bring together all of the votes for themselves in a ballot, the High King can decide whether to declare the candidate with the most votes the winner, or to have the candidates compete in a contest to determine the victor.
The coal fire is lit when the kingdoms meet for council. It has lain dormant much too long, until it was finally lit again a few days ago.
Ah, Tongdil, what is it?
The High King and his advisor don't know where I come from either. But they only want to use me to delay Gandagar's coronation and ultimately prevent war with the elves.
Whatever happens, we will stand by your side, scholar.
You're not sure whether the moral support of your friends will be much use in a contest with Gandagar, but it feels good not having to go through the whole thing on your own.
I think I'll continue to look around.
Don't get lost. And tonight, we will finally drink a lovely dark ale in the glowing anvil.
I think I first need to organize... Andekai, what is it?
I came to return these books to you, Tungdil. Luckily, I was able to make sense of most of it.
You observed how the Maegar took time to study the books during your escape.
They are records from the Outer Lands. They tell of demonic beings from Barren Ground who can take possession of humans and invest them with great power.
Immortality, for example?
The Maegar nod seriously.
They speak of an axe forged by the Undergrounders called Keenfire. It is said to have the power to cut through the flesh and bone of the living and completely destroy the demonic spirit deep within their soul.
So you think a demon from the Outer Lands has taken possession of Nudin?
He looked very different when I encountered him in Perista, and he rose from the dead even though you cut off his head. That can't be explained purely through the power of the perished land.
And he wanted to prevent these books from falling into our hands. That would only make sense if Keenfire had the power to defeat him. Where is this Keenfire?
I don't know if this weapon was ever forged. It requires rare materials and masterful craftsmanship. The purest, hardest steel, stone barbs decorated with runes, a hilt of Sigurdasi wood, inlays made of all the noble metals, the blades studded with diamonds, smithed in the hottest forge.
We are dwarves. We have the most talented craftsmen.
And you have the Sigurdasi wood. It is amongst the objects in your rucksack, which is fortunate as there are no more Sigurdasis in Girdlegard. But even if you managed to forge the axe, it might all be just a fairy tale. It's too little to wager our lives on.
Do you know these Undergrounders?
I have never heard of the Undergrounders, but I've been to the Outer Lands before.
It must be terrible. The hordes of Teon have marched from there against our strongholds for thousands of years.
It's not as bad as you think. It is certainly safer than a land in which a Magus possessed by a demon is on the loose.
We can get all the missing materials, as well as a gem cutter, here in the stronghold. After all, Gandagar and his fourthlings are here, a stonemason from the secondlings, and I can smith.
The Maegar looks at you thoughtfully, and for a short time it seems as though your enthusiasm is rubbing off on her. But then she says,
I wish you good luck, Tungdil.
You still want to leave Girdlegard, but what will happen to your realm and all the other realms?
I admire your optimism, my friend, but it isn't wise to stand in the way of a rolling stone. I don't wish to give up my realm, but I would only be prolonging the suffering unnecessarily.
But...
You don't want to let the last Maegar in Girdlegard go. Unfortunately, you can't think of anything that could cause her to stay.
Many thanks, Honorable Maegar, for all that you have done. A variety of cheeses, pickled cave mushrooms, toasted vault moss, and some smoked sausage. Mmm.
The intense smell of the cheese makes your mouth begin to water.
Garen found an answer to the threat. Keenfire. No matter how difficult it is to forge it, we must do it. We don't know of anything else that could injure a demon. Sigurdasi wood. Very rare. I guess Lot-Yonan wanted it to examine or experiment with.
Tungdil, what is it?
Andikai deciphered what was written in the books that Garen wanted to send to Turga the Fairfaced. They tell of a demonic threat from the Outer Lands and how it can be stopped. Nudin cannot be killed by normal weapons, but Undergrounders have developed a weapon that might be able to do it. Keenfire.
Undergrounders? What's that supposed to mean?
You shrug your shoulders.
Maybe there are dwarves in the Outlands too. Either way, they have described how this magical weapon can be made.
If it's got anything to do with magic, the weapon cannot be dwarfish. We shouldn't go anywhere near it.
Nudin fears the books. I believe that Keenfire is our best chance of stopping him. I think I'll continue to look around.
Don't get lost. And tonight, we will finally drink a lovely dark ale in the glowing anvil.
You are looking forward to the first proper bed for weeks. You undress and lie down. Before you know it, your eyes close and you fall asleep. When your new armor is brought to you the next morning, you can hardly believe your eyes. However, as a smith, you can't stand the fact that you haven't contributed anything to it, and decide to add some inlays.
Even one who wears the armor of a prince can still be a farrier underneath it, don't you think, Tungdil Bolifar?
Just like a snake in elegant clothing is still a snake.
Ignoring your question, Bislipur eyes you very exactly before he speaks.
So, you want to be one of our kingdom? A foundling brought up by a wizard? One wouldn't think it possible. And I don't think it possible either. There is no proof of your origin, and Gandagar's the council on his side. Why don't you spare yourself the disgrace and just not turn up in front of the council? Put your scheme to bed, and we will take you into our kingdom. We will give you everything you need your whole life long. In exchange, you support Gandagard instead of challenging him.
Proof! Oh, you mean like your letter that has been found after a thousand cycles and makes the elves responsible for the fall of the Fithlings?
It is no secret that the elves are deceitful. And what could possibly be more suited to get one over on us than letting the perished land in and presenting us as the scapegoat?
The elves have been displaced by the perished land and are now almost eradicated.
I said they are deceitful, not wise.
And what if I don't withdraw my candidacy?
You wish to stand against your own king? A stray dwarf offending a deserving leader such as Gandagar through his claim? No one in the Brown Range will like that. Prepare yourself for life as an outsider among the Forthlings.
Children of the Smith cannot be silenced.
You are a dwarf, I confess, but no Forthling can remember a dwarf child ever going missing.
And you know thousands of the Forthlings personally, and know exactly where they live in the mountains, what they're planning, or what small tragedies take place in their lives?
You have a sense that all the long evenings in the library and debating with Lot Yonan weren't for nothing, as Bislipur struggles for a reply, then lets it go. You have had enough of this dwarf. He makes you feel uneasy, or worse still.
Get out!
A humanized bastard will not issue me orders. Know your place, false dwarf.
Some of the gold has left a coin-sized mark on the back of your hand. It hurts, but you like the idea that a bit of the metal you love is now part of you. The armor has been made by a master. Over the chainmail is steel plate, alloyed with gold in many places, which certainly appeals to you. There are also several decorative elements made of stone to honor its origin in the kingdom of the best stonemasons. You had just finished setting the last inlay, the seal of Lot Yonan, who brought you up and is gone, when Bislipur interrupted you. You are looking for... You undress... When your new armor is brought...
Even one.
What do you...
But...
Proof
is the...
Chill and
you...
Get out!
A humanized bastard will not issue me orders. No, yeah.
Some of the gold is like... The armor has... You are...
Not only is it worthy of a king and fits me like a glove, but it should also offer me additional protection in battle. That is why I, too, lodge a claim to the throne and why I think I am the more capable heir.
Thank you for your speech, Tungdil Bolifar. The council may now ask questions.
Bislipper?
Nothing you say will convince anyone here. You didn't grow up amongst us, and no one knows if you really are a Fourthling. I do not believe there has ever been a more unworthy heir to the throne of the High King. You are just wasting our time.
It's true. I have nothing to present to you regarding my lineage that would eliminate all doubt. But is that really important? Shouldn't my deeds count for more than my lineage? Let me prove what I can achieve.
As long as he's capable.
Well, when you put it that way,
lineage is important.
And if you aren't capable of anything?
Yes, the dwarf from the Secondling Kingdom over there.
You say that a war against the elves would be madness, but how can such a young dwarf as you judge that? You've hardly seen anything of the world, has he?
It is true. There is much that I only know from books. But it is written that it is our duty to defend and protect Girdlegard, and that includes the elves. And don't the elves have the same enemy as we do? They could stand by us in battle. Why should we play into the hands of the enemy by attacking them rather than working against the enemy together?
That is true.
He's right.
The words of a clever warrior.
But the pointy ears hate us, and we hate them too.
What is it they say again? My enemy's enemy is my friend.
Yes? Your question?
Just so I get this right, you want to forge a weapon that is described in a book of fairy tales from the Perished Land to kill a demon that none of us has ever seen?
I have most definitely seen it, Goimgar, yellow belly Shimmerbeard.
No one knows for certain whether it is the solution, but does anyone have a better idea? We have to stop Nodon and the Perished Land.
That's true, but...
It'll work out somehow.
We should discuss other possibilities first.
I'm not convinced.
I have heard enough. The council has heard the words of both candidates and must now make its decision. Those of you who wish to see Tungdil Bolifar, the returning son from the Fourthling Kingdom, as my successor, raise your axe. And those who wish to see Gandagar Silverbeard from the Silverbeards, the King of the Fourthlings, as my successor. Gandagar has received more votes.
Very good.
Excellent.
Here's to Gandagar. Long live our new High King.
However, the result was not unanimous. And as acting High King, I avail myself of my right to demand a contest between the aspirants.
What is this?
But he won the ballot.
That's the rules. The High King has the right to do so.
Respect! He is still the High King.
Silence!
You have heard the High King's command. Write down your challenge for the aspirants. Are you ready? The one that masters this task first will become the High King. It is an expedition. The trial is to lead a group to forge the axe Keenfire in the Grey Range, which can then be used to fight against the Magus Nodon.
An expedition into the Perished Land?
Ha ha! Brilliant!
You can't be serious.
That's what I call a worthy challenge, don't you think?
I call it luck, scholar. Of all the challenges, Bishnapur draws this one.
Yes, luck.
But my king, don't demand this of me. Why me, of all people?
You are one of my best gem cutters, and I promise to support him. It should be a fair contest. Or should I break my word just because of you?
But...
You will go, Goimgar Shimmerbeard. Do not put us to shame. Follow Tungdil's instructions. Go, and come back in good health.
And with that, our group is complete.
Who have you chosen as Mason?
Good day, gentlemen.
Bavragar? The old drunkard?
Old drunkard? He assured me he's the best stonemason here. The High King himself sent him.
Well, I said I was precisely the stonemason you need. I didn't exactly say I was sent by the High King.
You let yourself be tricked by a drunkard.
I don't want him with us.
Rest assured, Boindil, I too could imagine better company. But Tungdil gave me his word.
Yes, I gave you my word. And as long as you are capable of doing the stonework needed for Keenfire, you are welcome. Girdlegard is at stake here.
I wish you no ill fortune, Tungdil. But also, no good fortune. The throne belongs to me. And through my victory, Vrakas will show the clans.
The task is clear to the contenders? The first to forge Keenfire and bring it back here has proven his abilities and will be our new High King to lead us in battle against Nod On.
It will take months to complete the task. The journey to the Fiflings alone is a long and dangerous business.
Dangerous, yes, but not necessarily long. Do you know the old tunnel system that connects the Dwarven Kingdoms?
Tunnels are all well and good, but why should we get there so much quicker under the ground than over it?
A knowing smile plays on the mouth of the advisor.
Well...
Impressive what our forefathers achieved here, isn't it?
The kingdoms all work together. If we do the same, nothing is impossible.
Hear, hear.
I still don't understand why you tricked me and why you were so set on coming with us.
I have been the Master of Stone for more than 200 sun cycles. My work is admired all over Girdlegard. There has never been a better secondling mason than me. But today,
I don't want to be remembered as a drunkard with the chisel trembling in my hand, but as Bavragor Amethyst, undefeated master of stone who brought keen fire to life. One last masterpiece.
You really should rein in your drinking. We need you in good shape.
There are some who say I'm only the master of beer and not the master of stone anymore. But don't worry. I haven't forgotten. I can't forget, no matter how much I drink.
I hope you understand me asking, but there seems to be bad blood between you and Boindil.
It's nothing that will endanger our mission. We've just always hated each other.
There's more behind it than commonplace hatred.
Bavragor doesn't react. His gaze is directed towards events that took place a long time ago.
I wonder why we haven't seen any sign of Gandagar recently. Perhaps they took a wrong turn somewhere. I'm sure we'll reach the Fifthling Kingdom before them.
We're not on the way to the Fifthlings. We are on the way to the Firstlings. We're probably already under the land of the Custodian.
The Firstlings? Why?
The Firstlings have been the best smiths in Girdlegard since the Fifthlings were wiped out. Only they can alloy Tionium and Palladium, which are actually mutually repellent. Anyway, we could use all the help we can get in the battle against Nodon, and... Goimgar!
It burns!
We won't get further this way, Scholar! What now?
It's all your fault, you imposter! I was nearly killed, and for what?
It is good that you are still alive. We need you for our mission.
So you can steal a throne that doesn't belong to you?
Hatred glints in the gem cutter's eyes, and for a moment, you think he's going to attack you with the courage of desperation.
I'm not interested in the title of High King. I am trying to save Girdlegard. Even if you don't believe anything else, you must believe this.
I don't have to believe anything. I am here against my will. My own thoughts are my only remaining right.
Enough! Gather up all the materials we can still save. If we manage to reach the Firstlings, we can get anything we're missing there. And it should be less than 200 miles to their stronghold.
After you have gathered together the materials, you begin to search for a way out. And after a sweaty climb, you reach a door adorned with runes. From here, you enter a large cave with a waterfall covering a sun-drenched opening. You walk through the waterfall one after another, and after the unintentional shower, you find yourselves in Weyen, near the enchanted realm of Oromyra. You find yourselves on a plateau, and the river, which falls as a waterfall here, hides the entrance to the underground rail network. It then flows past a forest, behind which you can see a wall and tiled roofs. You check the map.
That must be Mithridatia. We'll go through the forest to the city and see if we can refresh our supplies and buy some ponies.
Get out!
Are you?
Some of the. The are you?
Not only. That is why I, too, lodge a claim to...
No!
It's true. I... Yes. It is true.
I don't...
He's...
But the... What is...
Yes?
Just so I have...
We have seen the Perish Land with our own eyes, and its master Nodon could not be killed. Many have died for the books in which it is written how keen fire can be made, and the Magus did all he could to get his hands on the two hafts made of Sigar Daisy wood. Those are the facts, whether you like them or not. These problems won't solve themselves, so I ask you, is it the Dwarven way to step aside and do nothing, or is it our way to act?
To act!
We don't hide away!
If the humans won't stop the Perish Land, then we will!
We shouldn't get drawn in!
Let's show the Magus the strength of the Dwarves!
I have heard enough! The Council has heard the words of both candidates, and must now make its decision. Those of you who wish to see Tungdil Bolifar, the returning son from the Fourthling Kingdom, as my successor, raise your axe. And those who wish to see Gandagar Silverbeard from the Silverbeards, the King of the Fourthlings, as my successor. Gandagar has
very good.
Here's to long live.
However, the result.
But he won the.
It's the
respect.
Silence.
You.
Are you ready? The one.
You.
That's what I call a worthy...
I call...
Yes.
But my...
You are one of...
But...
You will go, going...
And with that...
Who have you... Good.
The task is clear to the contenders.
We're not on the way. We are off the... Damn. Goimgar. It is. I'm in.
After you...
That must... That is why I, too, lost that. Bishop North! A new perspective is sure to be good for the dwarves. As an outsider, I will be a breath of fresh air and bring new ideas.
Might be true.
We don't need to be told this by some spring chicken.
We know ourselves what's best.
Fresh air. Close the window.
There's no reason to change anything.
Yes, the dwarf...
You say...
If we get drawn into a conflict against the elves, then we are no better than the Alfar who have fought with the elves for thousands of cycles.
He's right.
Well...
Of course we're better than the Alfar!
Outrageous.
Yes?
Just till I get this right.
I have most definitely.
We have seen the Perished Land with the
two.
If the we let.
Very good.
Here, look how. What is.
Buddy, what?
It's the risk.
Silence! Are you the.
And you.
That's what I call a worthy challenge.
Oh, yeah.
But.
Yeah. Good day. Yeah. The task.
We are the damn Goimgar. It is. I'm not in.
After you have. You.
Thank you. That is why I... Oh, I didn't know you were the spokesperson for everyone at this assembly, Bislipper. I had the impression that every dwarf is capable of forming their own opinion.
Absolutely.
Hear, hear!
He's right, you know.
Keep out of it, Bislipper.
Yes, the dwarf from the Secondling Kingdom over there.
You say that a...
It is true.
And don't...
What's that?
These words...
But the point...
What is...
Yes?
It just...
I have...
We have seen the Parish Land. Those are the facts, whether you...
To act!
We don't...
If the humans won't stop, we shouldn't... Let's show the Magus the strength.
I have heard enough. The Council has heard the words of both candidates and must now make its decision. Those of you who wish to see Tungdil Bolifar, the returning son from the Fourthling Kingdom, as my successor, raise your axe. And those who wish to see Gandagar Silverbeard from the Silverbeards, the King of the Fourthlings, as my successor. It's close, but Gandagar has received more votes.
Very good.
Excellent.
Here's to Gandagar! Long live our new High King!
However, the result was not unanimous, and as acting High King, I avail myself of my right to demand a contest between the aspirants.
What is this?
But he won the ballot.
That's the rules. The High King has the right to do so.
Respect! He is still the High King.
Silence!
You have heard the High King's command. Write down your challenge for the aspirants. Are you ready? The one that masters this task first will become the High King. It is...
An ex...
You can't be...
That's what I call a worthy...
I call...
Yes.
But, my king, don't demand this of me.
You...
Good day, gentlemen.
The task is clear to the contender.
It will date
to-
and-
We're not on the way to the Fifthling. We are on the Firstlings have... Damn. Goimgar. It is so. I'm not interested in the title of High King. I am trying.
I don't have to believe.
Enough!
After you have gathered together the materials, you begin to search for a way out. And after a sweaty climb, you reach a door adorned with runes. From here, you enter a large cave with a waterfall covering a sun-drenched opening. You walk through the waterfall one after another, and after the unintentional shower, you find yourselves in Weyen, near the enchanted realm of Oromyra. You find yourselves on a plateau, and the river, which falls as a waterfall here, hides the entrance to the underground rail network. It then flows past a forest, behind which you can see a wall and tiled roofs. You check the map.
That must be Mifidalia. We'll go through the forest to the city and see if we can refresh our supplies and buy some ponies.